And hello dear friends, welcome back once again to our channel Vagai Academy of Mathematics, and this playlist is where you can find video lessons for CAT, MAT and other management exams. This session we have an interesting question from Time and Work, and that too, this kind of problems you can definitely see in many exams. When you are practicing also, this kind of problems you would have definitely solved, at least few problems you would have solved from Time and Work. So such an important question, and that too, students are still worrying about how to do these kind of problems. So now we'll take a good approach how to solve this kind of problem. Yes, okay, come on. Yeah, here our question with us. Let's go to the question. 4 men and 15 boys can complete a work in 56 days. So we'll note down the information. So 4 men, first we have 4 men and 15 boys. They will complete the task, some task in 56 days they give, okay. And next info we have, 10 men and 10 boys can complete the same work in 40 days. So we note down that also, 10 men and how many? 10 boys. So they are completing the same work in how many days? They are given it to be 40 days. So then what about the question? The question is, then in how many days 19 men and 40 boys can complete the same task? This is the question. So we'll note down it, 19 men and 40 boys. So they will complete the work in how many days? So this is going to be the question. So now we will see some approach. So these kind of questions are what going to be a little bit confusing for students or aspirants. Like this kind of questions, it is involving men as well as boys. So by what approach we can solve these kind of questions if you ask? It's going to be very simple. We will try to get a relation between the manpowers or their efficiencies, okay, right? So we'll try to find the efficiency, the ratio or the comparison between one man and one boy, so that relation will help us to substitute it back in the question itself, so that we can convert all of them, the entire group itself, to either men or two boys. So we'll convert all of them to a unique personality, like either we'll convert everyone to be men or everyone to be boys, then that will be helping us to solve the problem more easily. So this is going to be the plan how we are going to execute this problem. Yes, for which what steps we are going to follow, that only matters, okay. So see here we have two informations given and one question is asked. So this is also like in this question also, it is like the work is going to be a constant. So if work is constant, definitely manpower and time, they are going to be inversely proportional. And at the same time, we have seen the men days concept, right? M1T1 is same as M2T2. So we are going to use that same relation only here also to solve this problem, or we are going to use that relation only, that equation only, to get a relation between men and boys. So we are going to do that. For that, carefully see here, our man one here is like this entire team. This is our M1, and this 56 days, what we have is our T1. Okay, yes, yeah, fine. And next is, this entire team is like M2, man 2, and this is like T2. So now we can better use our relation. We'll construct the equation, okay? So we need more space. So let me just break the board like this. So we'll work out one part here, the other part remaining left over here, okay? Yeah, first we have M1, T1. Okay, M1, T1 will be like 56 into 4M plus 15B. So I'm writing in short, okay, men is M, boys is B. So this will be same as M2 into T2, that is 40 into, so this side we have got 40 into 10M plus 10B. We have it like this. So now what we can do is we'll try to simplify this equation, and we'll try to bring or get a relation between men and boys. All right, yeah. Now when we continue the same way, we can just first of all simplify these two numbers actually, 56 and 40. There are two numbers are here, right? So I can just cut these two numbers with 8 tables. So we'll have 8 sevens are and 8 fives are. Okay. So done. Next, what we can do is we can just multiply the 7 inside, so that we'll get 28 men plus 105 boys, because 7 fours are 28, 7 15s are 105. So this will be equal to, come to the right hand side, we have 50. So 50N plus again 5 tens are again 50 boys. So we have got like this. Again continue it. So when we want to continue it, we have to bring boys terms to one side I mean B terms one side and M terms to the other side. So we'll do that. So if we try to do that, we'll be getting 105B. Let us have boys in the left hand side itself. 105B minus 50B, because that is plus 50B there. So that comes here, minus 50B. And this side, right hand side, we have 50 men minus this 28 men will go there. So minus 28 men. So continuing this, we get 55B is equal to, here we have 50 minus 28, 22M. All right, everything is clear, right? So now we have got 55B is equal to 22M. We can simplify with numbers also. It's very clearly seen both are divisible by 11. So in that case, when I divide both sides by 11, we get 5B is equal to 2M. I hope everything is clear to you till this step. Okay, each and every step is very much important here. So carefully analyze what we are doing so far. We are just using that Mendes concept. Okay, so M1T1 is equal to M2T2. So we are just taking that M1T1 left hand side, M2T2 right hand side. And from there, we are just simplifying all the steps. Finally, we are getting a clear relation between boys and men. So that means what we are getting is 5 boys is equal to 2 men. This is what we are getting. So that is strength wise or efficiency wise, if you compare, strength of 5 boys is same as the strength of 2 men. This is what this relation is coming to deliver. Yes, okay, fine. Now up to this is done. Now what we are going to do? So as we planned in the beginning itself, we will be converting either all of the people to men or all of them to boys. That depends on problem, okay? But in whatever way we perform, we will be getting the answer. That is sure. But based on how we have the numbers in the question, we have to think in a wise way, we have to plan in a wise way, and in that way we have to perform the problem. Okay, so 5 boys is equal to 2 men. This is what the relation we are getting. Once again, go to the question here. So question, see here, we have got nice numbers for boys here. Since we have comfortable number for the number of boys, let us just convert the number of boys to be number of men using this relation. Okay, so let's try to substitute this relation here in the first equation that is given for us, I mean the first statement. So when we try to do that, we have here 4 men and 15 boys, is it or not? So now see this 15 boys, we know 5 boys is equal to 2 men. Let us just try to replace that 15 boys as men. Okay, so see here, 15 boys is equal to, see, 5 boys is equal to 2 men that we have. So 5, 3 times is what is here. So the team is becoming thrice. So in the case, 5 threes are is 15. So the same happens to the right hand side also. 2 threes are will be 6. So 6 men. So I'm going to replace this 15 boys as 6 men now. So it will become 4 men and 6 men again. Okay, so this team is going to finish the work in how many days? They are going to complete it in 56 days, right? So the same thing happens here also. 4 men and 6 men means it's going to be totally 10 men. So 10 men can complete the work in 56 days. Then continue the question. Continue. What we are asked to find? 19 men and 40 boys can complete the work in how many days? This is going to be the question, right? So in the case, what we will be having here is, we are going to do the same thing here also. 19 men and 40 boys. Again, we are going to change this entire team to be number of men itself. Okay, we'll do that. So this is equal to, so here also we'll try to do the same thing. 19 men and 40 boys, right? Okay, 19 men, we'll have it as it is. Come to this 40 boys. So 40 boys is equal to, again, compare with the first relation that we have already here. So 5 boys is 2 men. So 5 and 40, just compare it. It is going to be exactly 8 times, right? So the same thing happens to the right hand side also. 2 8s are. So 2 8s are will be 16. So 16 men. So we can very well replace this 40 boys as how many men now? 16 men. So we'll do that. So 19 men and again 16 men. So this will be once again equal to, what is 19 plus 16? Now we have changed everything to men, right? We can directly add it. 19 plus 16 will be equal to 35 men, right? So 35 men will complete the work in how many days? This is going to be the question. So now our question is looking very simple, like how we started in the beginning time. So it's going to be appear, it is appearing in a very simple terms, right? 10 men can finish a work in 56 days. Then 35 men can finish the same work in how many days? That's all. So we are trying all these things. We are trying all these doing. We are just doing all these equations and framing and everything just to make this conversion only. Okay. So we have succeeded in that. Now the way of answering the question is going to be very, very easy. 10 men, 56 days. Then 35 men, how many days? The work is going to be the same only, right? So what we can do, I'm going to write it in a fresh way. So 10 men, it is taking, they are taking how many days? 56 days. Then our question is like 35 men. See here, 35 men is this team, okay? Because this is what is asked in the question, okay? So 35 men, how many days? This is question, right? So we can just use the ratio concept itself, right? See here, men we have 10 and 35. What's the ratio of 10 is to 35? It's going to be, in 5 tables if we cancel, we'll get 2 and 7, right? So this is going to be 2 is to 7. So I'm going to write like 2 is to 7 here, 2 is to 7. So right hand side, what will happen? That will be 7 is to 2, right? Okay, so 7 is to 2 we will be getting. So 7 parts is like 56 days. Then 2 parts is how much? So 7 and 56, just see and say, compare. 7 eighths are will give you 56, and do the same here. 2 eighths are, what will be the answer? It's going to be 16. So 16 days is going to be the answer for this question. And our answer is available at option B, 16 days. This is going to be the answer. So I hope you are clear with the plan, what we are doing. So we'll just summarize it. Since it's a very lengthy problem, we'll just summarize it. Here we are given two informations. So we are having the manpower, the team, as men as well as boys. So what we will try to do is, with this information, what we'll try to do now, we'll just try to frame or get a relation between boys' power and men's power. I mean the efficiency, we are just comparing their efficiency. So we are getting a relation. We'll try to use this relation again back in the question itself, so that we can convert the entire team to be either men or boys. So we are converting everyone to be men itself. So because of very comfortable numbers we have for boys, we are converting all to men. And then we are using our classical the approach, men time and men and days concept to solve the problem. We are just using the ratio concept to solve the problems, and hence we are getting the answer. So answer 16 is going to be, 16 days is going to be the answer for this particular question. I hope you are clear with these steps and everything in order to solve this problem. And even if you have got any doubts, you are most welcome to comment in the comment box. And if you have any similar problems to be worked out, you can just comment it that also. So I'll try to post the solution for those questions also, any harder questions if you come across. Fine, yes. I hope everything is clear, and I just insist you to please like our this video, and do share this video to your friends also, those who are preparing for any such management exams. Again, we'll catch up in the next session with some other interesting question. See you soon there. Thank you so much.